aqua. Okay. So now you can see that the beads on this cycle rim are very close to the axle, and this is a very good demonstration to show the centrifugal force. Now when I turn this one, in the rotational frame of reference, if you want to apply the Newton's laws of force, you have to use the pseudo force concept. Now, if I gradually rotate this one, all the beads are moving away from it. Suppose if I move very faster, so all the beads are moving away from this one. Now we can stop it even. See, now that you can observe the position of the beads. Before turning, all the beads were at very near to it. Let's do once again. So this concept will explain what is actually the centrifugal force. In fact, it happens in the churning and even in the water washing machines and centrifugation in the chemistry lab. So now let me do it once again. Now you can see all the beads are at the center. Now when I rotate it, they will go away from the center, and because of the centrifugal force. Okay, now let me do it. Okay, now I'll stop this. You can see the beads position. Come closer. So now, I'm standing in between the two whispering boards. So these boards will explain. Actually, the shape of this board is concave. And here, this ring is situated at the focus of it. Now when the sound waves, when I speak from this particular position, if a boy is, keeping his ear there, even if I whisper here, the sound waves will move parallel. Why? Because I am releasing the sound waves from the focus of this one. So any wave that is hitting this board will be moved in a parallel direction, and all these parallel waves will go and hit that board, and they will be again reflected back, and this rays will be reflected back through this focus. Now if anybody keeps the ear here, they can listen to me. Okay, now let's keep the camera here very nearby so that one can listen to my voice. You also just put your ear here. Okay, keep the camera very near to that. Hello, can you listen to me? 1, 2, 3, 4. Hello, hello. Is it clear?
Yes.
Are you listening to me?
Hello. Sir.
Hello.
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 Hello. Hello.
Hello. Is it listening?
Yes.
Then keep the camera just very nearby at the point, focus only. So that you can keep the mic, you can keep the speaker at the focus. Now I'll be talking there.
Hello. Hello.
Hello. This is the principle of the whispering boards. The waves that are moving parallel to this, they will be merging at a particular point called focus. At the focus, I kept my microscope through which you can listen to the sound. Hello. Hello. Check 1, 2, 3. Okay. It's done through the electrons. The
device is called yo-yo. Now we have wrapped the wire. Now when we leave it, it is uncoiled, but again it goes in the upward direction. The potential energy is converted into rotational kinetic energy, and again rotational kinetic energy is again converted into potential energy. So now that the potential energy is higher because it is having certain height from the ground, now you can see it's coming down. It loses its potential energy and gaining the rotational kinetic energy, and because of rotation again it's getting back to certain height. Hello, this this is one of the best demonstrations for Newton's third law. Now I am sitting on a chair. If I move this in one particular direction, now I am moving in the opposite direction. So you can say that action and reaction are in opposite directions. So when I leave it, you just see. Once again, I am pushing this in one direction. I am going back in the opposite direction. I am pushing this in this direction, and the person sitting on the chair will be moved in the opposite direction. Even you can see the dome of it, how it rotates. Let us consider two points on board. One side the cage is there, on the other side the parrot is there. Now our eyes can see the motion pictures if the frame rotates in very fast manner. Now I'll be rotating the frame. You will see as if the parrot is appeared in the cage. That is, if the amount of charge. Okay. This is called the sympathetic pendulum. In this, there are two pendulums. In one side, one pendulum and one swing. He is sitting in the other swing. I am sitting here. So if one of us move, then automatically the second person will be moved. Now here what you have to observe is the amplitude of the first person will be reduced first, and gradually the amplitude of the second person will be increased. Now I'll only move. Okay. So now you can see that the beads on this cycle rim are very close to the axle, and this is a very good demonstration to show the centrifugal force. Now when I turn this one in the rotational frame of reference, if you want